Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. This is Nick Ross, guys. And we are here in what I'm gonna call the Mecca of bodybuilding in the Cayman Islands, King's Powerhouse Gym. This is actually the first gym I've ever been to in my whole entire life. I believe I was 14 years old, and I was brought here by a PE class, and you know, it was whatever. Fast forward another 6-7 years, 21 years old now, came back to the gym for the first time. It is absolutely amazing. This gym is completely transformed. It is just so, you know, bodybuilding. Like, they have all the Mr. Olympias listed on the wall. I didn't show you guys, I should have shown you that, but all the Mr. Olympias on the wall. And I talked to one of the employees. They gave me a day free pass and they gave me permission to film. It's real cool, and it's so easy to film in this gym. It's so easy. Like, all the equipment is like right next to each other. You can set the cameras up so well. It's very nice, and I'm definitely looking into getting a membership here. I mean, it's so cool. And I call it the Mecca because, I mean, it's a bodybuilding gym. I mean, it has so much equipment. It's so, like, there's so many big guys in here too. It's just a great environment for bodybuilding, great environment to work out. Right here, I got a leg workout for you guys. 9 weeks out leg workout. Started with some squats. Started with 135, then worked my way up to 225. And I know what you guys are thinking, why not go heavier? I can squat well over 300 pounds for reps, but not every single workout is gonna consist of just heavy lifts. Sometimes you need to go in that 12, 15, 20 rep range to just get more blood in the area. Sometimes you need to change it up. Sometimes you need to do something a little bit more different. Do what you've always done. You'll look like you always have. So I do change things up from time to time. So doing a lot of drop sets as of lately. Trying to get more blood in the muscle, blood in the area. And I kind of have this theory. I kind of have this thought and idea that you can kind of, I guess you can say, promote the development of muscle maturity. I was looking at a few young bodybuilders online, and you know, you have some guys that are 19, 20, 21 years old with just such advanced development. Particularly one guy, Cody Lewis. He's a pro bodybuilder. At age of 19 years old, his leg development was ridiculous. Like, he had definition that some 35-year-old guys had. It was completely his legs, man. Damn, y'all. I'll just link a video to his leg workout so you guys can see his leg development. Ridiculous. But what he does is just a lot of reps, a lot of drop sets, just a massive amount of reps and drop sets. This guy would incorporate probably 65 to 75 reps within one set from doing drop sets. Like, it was just maddening. So I kind of had this thought that maybe there's something behind that, you know, with creating muscle maturity. Doing a lot of reps, I definitely think stimulates the muscle in a different way that's going to definitely add definition. Because you can take a powerlifter and you can take a bodybuilder. Bodybuilding parameters, call it 12 to 15 reps. Powerlifting parameters, 1 to 2 reps. Now, powerlifters have pretty much absolutely zero definition. Definition is just non-existent on their body. Whereas a bodybuilder now, definition from head to toe, feathered from head to toe. So I do think that those reps definitely do play a role in just adding definition, just creating that separation lines. I really do believe that. So that is a reason why you're seeing me doing a lot of drop sets and a lot of reps in my legs right now. Going a little bit more lighter, just focusing on the squeezing, the contracting, trying to get as much blood in the area as possible. And like I say, the idea behind that is just to promote definition, promote the development of more definition. I don't really struggle a lot with leg definition because I've been doing a lot of high reps, you know, in the past. You know, like, I already have feathers on my quads. I'm getting veins. I have pretty nice separation. My hamstrings are looking pretty sliced. You'll see that in a little bit. I did some stiff-legged deadlifts and some leg curls. And, you know, it's looking pretty good. So my leg definition is there. You know, at this point, just a matter of just fine-tuning and just body fat, just reducing the body fat. And that's what I've been doing. That's what I'm working on. And not to say that I'm not lifting heavy. I mean, I am definitely still doing my 4-rep maxes and just trying to, you know, keep the heavy lows. You need that. Especially as a natural bodybuilder who's contest prepping, low carb, cardio out the ass. You know, you definitely do need those heavy poundages. So it's a mix of both. You need to understand how to use certain tools like drop sets, supersets, low reps, high reps, heavyweight, lightweight. You need to understand what all those do for your body, and you need to understand how to incorporate all those things. So once that is better understood by you through proper education and reading and articles and asking people advice, all these other things, then you get a better understanding of how you should execute your workout routine. So I ranted on a little bit there, but I mean, I thought I should share that with you guys. Right now, I'm doing some leg extensions. And as you can see, I mean, my leg definition, it was pretty funny. Like, I actually didn't know this before in the past, but when my quads fill up with blood, my definition just goes away. Like, no lines, no separation, no feathers, nothing. And my quads right now are very feathered. And for me to just have no feathering at all during a workout is, I never really noticed that. I mean, my body fat hasn't really been this low for me to notice. But I guess from me having so much blood in that muscle, it just fills in the lines. I mean, essentially, yeah, like, just think about a rock with dents. If you pour water in the dents that, pour water in the rock that has a dent, then it'll be smooth, right? Just a smooth surface. There'll be no dents, there'll be no insertion. So that's like the muscle, but with blood. The blood gets in the fibers, it gets in the fascia tissue, and it just fills in those lines for the time being. Just think about it as you're pushing nutrients in the muscle. So for the time being, the definition is gone. Like, I just did a quick leg posing right there for you guys. You just saw a little bit of my legs. As you can see, there was like pretty much no definition there because I got so much blood in the area. But, you know, I mean, as of right now, like, I'm talking to you, I mean, it's 2 days after the workout. My legs are, you know, all the blood is gone, and, you know, feathering is back. So if you ever notice that, I mean, don't be too worried about it. That's actually why people should not pump up their legs for competition backstage. You should never pump up legs, never, before you step on stage, because it will take away from definition. Having blood in every single body part besides legs is beneficial. But once you, like, squat for legs backstage, trying to pump your legs up, yeah, you know, you might get some vascularity. Yeah, some vascularity will come along, but what about the separation, the definition, the feathering? You're not going to have that because you're pumping your legs up, filling it with up with blood. What that's going to do is allow the blood to get into the separated lines and take away from definition. And you don't want that. You want to be separated from head to toe. You want to be feathered. Something that I actually just figured out during this workout, thank God. Because, I mean, I don't know, I might have squatted or I might have tried to get some blood in my quads backstage. So I'm learning as I go along. I'm learning little tricks, little things. I'm trying to understand my body. I'm learning more of my body more and more every single day, if not every single week. And it's just definitely knowledge that I'm going to apply. Helping me out a lot. And, you know, things are working. Things are happening for me. So, I mean, I'm going to leave you guys with that. That's the end of the video. Nick Ross, Body of Legends, guys. Tune in to next time. Got a few good videos up. Check out all the new videos on the channel, guys. See you next time. Take it easy. Bye-bye. What's up, guys? Nick Ross of Body of Legends right here. Make sure to follow me on all my social media sites in the description. Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, even Tumblr. Follow me everywhere, guys. Keep up with all my updates and all my posts and all my photos and all my motivations and everything that I have to offer right down in the description. See you next time.